live reenactment of me during this movie. Godzilla vs. Kong is a film I've been looking forward to for years, and now we have it, 49 years after the original. It's surprising they didn't wait until the 50th anniversary, but I'm not complaining. So here are my spoiler-free thoughts. I'm a massive Godzilla fan. I own all the films on DVD and Blu-ray, and I've watched them ever since I was a kid. It's like my original fandom, and probably my most niche nerd place thing, whatever. In short, I loved it, and I will be able to rewatch this pretty much anytime. It's too bad all the surprises were leaked by toy lines, marketing, or trailers. It lessened the impact for me for sure. It kind of happened with previous films too. And it makes me want to avoid film marketing completely and go in blind, no trailers or anything. But I love trailers, so it's hard to stay away. The script isn't great. It's very direct with pretty much zero characterization. There are shallow characters and flat humor galore. Seriously, they forced too many jokes in on this one. And for everyone that lands, there are three that don't. And it just comes off as corny. It's not offensive or anything, but I felt nothing during the jokes. And again, same for the characters. It's easier to care for the ones from the previous film as we have their backstory. But the film doesn't care if it develops them further or if we get to know them. It cares about getting them from point A to point B, quite literally sometimes. It's stock human story filler from the Godzilla classics of old. But at least in this one, the stock human filler story furthers the world building, which is really exciting because there's a lot of directions that could go at this point if they decided to continue the MonsterVerse, but it also could end here if needed. We may do a spoiler talk later on. I may do a spoiler talk later on to go into this more, but I think the film knows and embraces these flaws, giving us true spectacle at a breakneck pace. Maybe a little too quickly, because there's not quite enough breathing room and it ends pretty abruptly. Sort of a shame, but man, when it is going, it is going. The visuals and the big matchups do not disappoint. These are some of the absolute greatest kaiju monster fights ever put to the screen, and that's why I'm here. I could rewatch these scenes over and over, and I smile throughout a large chunk of this movie, except for some of the dumb humor. As we get lots of monster screen time, can't complain with that. I was just disappointed they didn't do more with what was set up in the previous films in the cinematic universe. This is the shortest MonsterVerse film by far, and it's very tightly constructed. Again, a bit too tight, as lots of really cool ideas and pieces of lore are wasted and or glossed over. It doesn't match the cinematic love letter that is Godzilla King of the Monsters, which is my favorite of this universe, and the score isn't nearly as memorable as Bear McCreary's, but it's still an admirable job in Godzilla vs. Kong by Tom Holkenborg or Junkie XL. It's also not as well directed or shot as the 2014 Godzilla film, and it's much more confident and consistent in tone than Kong Skull Island. It's a brainless good time, and I think everyone could use a big, dumb, fun movie right now, given the times that we're in. If this is the end of the MonsterVerse, I'm happy, but I certainly hope there is more, as the potential is there. And I really want to see a modern take on Gigan. Please and thank you. I give Godzilla vs. Kong 4 out of 5 stars. Pure spectacle, baby. Subscribe, or else I'll get depressed and not make any more of these. Yeah, I'm not above guilt trips.